Starting off the day in St. Albans, not going to do much narrating today because as you can tell, my voice is a little off. We got 108 sitting right here with the Vermonter, kicking off hopefully a successful day of train watching here in St. Albans.
Amtrak train number 55, the southbound Vermonter, prepares to depart its origin of St. Albans. What remains of the former Central Vermont station is now owned by New England Central, and housed the railroad's dispatchers until early February, just days before this video was filmed.
St. Albans police, rapidly moving through town.
With Amtrak gone, I move up to North Elm Street to watch NECR Yard Job 501. NECR SD9 number 1750 has powered this job for years, but the EPA has ordered parent company Genesee in Wyoming to destroy it along with 87 other locomotives. The 1750 rarely leaves St. Albans, meaning North Elm Street is the most common location to shoot this unique locomotive. As 501 continues to work the yard, Train 500, the chip train, pulls down the bypass with Buffalo and Pittsburgh GP40 number 3000, hauling the train south to Burlington.
Thank you.
The chip train runs approximately 5 days a week out of St. Albans, delivering wood chips from Swanton to Burlington Electric and bringing the empties back north to repeat the process week after week, year after year. New England Central's trains operate using a time-efficient track warrant system that allows trains to follow each other, such as 500 following Amtrak's Vermonter every weekday morning. Island Line Rail Productions and I watched the 1750 work the yard for most of the morning, preparing cars for Canadian National M324. St. Albans is essentially the northern terminus of the New England Central. The Roxbury sub runs south towards White River Junction with a branch towards Burlington. The Swanton sub runs north to the Canadian border, where it connects with Canadian National's Rouse's Point sub. While the so-called Rail City is a shadow of what it once was, NECR, Amtrak, and CN keep this northern Vermont city a fairly busy rail location. The 1750 is one of the most unique locomotives on the railroad. The SD9 was built in 1959 for the DMIR and eventually found its way to the NECR, having lost some, but not all, of its high hood. When I scripted the video in May 2023, the unit was still in operation, but if the EPA has its way, it will be permanently destroyed sometime soon. while 501 switches, the St. Albans shop crew shuffles power as they perform their regular servicing duties.
Thank you.
watch as 501 clears the crossing here. Two cars cross dangerously close to the train, even failing to stop at the stop sign just before the crossing.
Multiple trains moving here, 1750 coming across, and they're also moving the road power. Thank you.
After a great morning of switching action, 501 shoves back into the yard and goes off duty. Our action is far from over, because Canadian National M324 has just gotten permission into the St. Albans yard.
Thank you.
Back at North Elm Street, CN works to drop their train in the yard. By this time, 500 is on its way north and will run up the main around the working 324.
Chase time, let's go. They don't fly, but the speed limits around here are relatively low, anywhere from 40 to 25 miles per hour. Let's get ready to keep chasing this thing.
After running around their train and attaching their caboose, 500 shoves north into Swanton.
Give me four more. Four.
I quickly move over to South River Street for CN 323 roaring north towards Montreal.
Those things go. Let's get on the chase.
I conclude my day in East Alberg as 323 crawls across Lake Champlain on the old Central Vermont trestle.
The reason I'm not narrating this video on the spot is because my voice sounds like this. But don't worry, myself in a few weeks will have a great voice, which is what you'll have been listening to this entire video. What a great day we've had though. My most successful day ever on the NECR, if not my most successful day in Vermont, period, ever. Amtrak 108. NECR 1750. Buffalo and Pittsburgh 3000 on the chip train. And of course a CN 100 unit leading 323 in beautiful evening light.